So if we go ahead with our simplifications, qv cross qu, which is the surface normal, the modified surface normal, n prime, is equal to pv cross pu, which is the original surface normal, okay, minus, then we are going to have du pu plus dv pv. Okay, so what does it represent? It says that I am going to have the original surface normal. Okay, so let's say we have the original surface normal. Here we have n. Now this original surface normal n is perturbed by a vector along the minus pu and minus pv direction. Okay, so let's say this is the minus pu direction. Okay. And so let me clear this part. And this is the minus PV direction. Okay, so minus PV direction. Let's clear this part. Now, du units along, I will go du units along PU. Okay, so I'll go like this much. And dv units along PV. So I'll go this much, let's say. Okay, now let's connect these things. So what I am doing is I am computing this vector. Okay, so this vector is on the tangent plane. This red one is on the tangent plane. So I'm adding this vector. Okay, so it's this vector. It's equal to it's this vector. Okay, so I'm adding this vector on n to find the perturbed surface normal. So the perturbed surface normal, if you show this with a different color, the perturbed surface normal is going to look like this. Okay, so the modification should actually, the perturbation should not make the surface normal point in an opposite direction. It should simply tilt it towards the tangent plane, depending on the magnitude of this perturbation.